As the price of Bitcoin keeps going up, its coverage in the media has also skyrocketed. And while Bitcoin has taken the world by storm with the reinvention of money, very few know of the wave of innovation happening just next door in the world of decentralized finance. Decentralized finance, or DeFi, is an ecosystem of blockchain-powered protocols that aim to democratize all kinds of financial services by providing them without the institution in the middle. Imagine lending and borrowing money directly from a protocol without a bank involved. Trading crypto, buying and selling stocks, leveraging options and futures without a brokerage. Getting insurance without an insurance company. A DeFi protocol is just code that has all the required rules to allow it to provide a financial service without people or a company involved. But before we dive into this world, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss another Lightbulb moment like this. To understand the decentralized finance, or DeFi revolution, let's first take a look at the problems with traditional financial services. Ever wondered why wire transfers and checks take days to clear? Existing financial services are built on infrastructure that is decades old. Wire transfers, card payments, checks, and even stock purchases actually take several days to clear because the technology used requires them to jump through lots of hoops to verify that the money exists and was transferred successfully. While there are applications that make it appear instant for the user, the underlying transaction actually takes days to go through. For a single transaction to clear through traditional payment rails, we need banks, clearinghouses, insurance companies, and many other parties involved. An entire industry designed around ensuring that a transaction goes through successfully. And even with all these institutions, one-third of the world's population is unbanked, and even more don't have access to basic financial services like borrowing and lending, insurance, equity markets, and such. So, what is DeFi and what exactly are these projects doing? Imagine that you can get access to all the same financial services anywhere in the world with just a smartphone, in a manner that is vastly more secure and foolproof with no overhead or middlemen involved. No brainer, huh? This is the core premise of decentralized finance, taking existing financial infrastructure and using the magic of blockchain and cryptography to offer the same services to everyone in the world without the inefficiencies and middlemen. One of the wonders of the internet is that it's the same for pretty much everyone around the globe. DeFi does the same thing for financial services. Take lending and borrowing for example. If you have money in an American bank account, it'll earn you less than 1% in interest per year, not even enough to beat inflation. At the same time, there are lots of people in various parts of the world unable to get loans even though they're willing to pay high interest rates and provide collateral. Some of the biggest DeFi projects aim to solve this problem by arbitraging this discrepancy. Just like a bank, you stake your dollar coins with the project. They give out collateralized loans to people who really need them and pay you 10 to 20% APY. And all of this happens automatically through code, without middlemen charging huge fees. Better than that high-yield savings account offering 1.2%, huh? The level of risk varies with the project, but there are several projects that have very conservative lending protocols that require lots of collateral. For people in a lot of parts of the world, access to capital and financial services like this is literally life-changing. And because this is all determined by code, there's no discrimination. It doesn't matter if you're a big American bank or a struggling artist in India, code is the same for everyone. Your money is the same as a billionaire's money. Because your money is being moved around by software, there's no room for human error or discrimination. This is why blockchain systems are called trustless. You don't have to trust a middleman. Code is law, and in most of these projects, everyone can see the code. Financial services enforced by a code that everyone can see is better than financial services which operate at the discretion of a bank employee. Of course, this is also one of the big risks with DeFi. The lack of human middlemen mean there's no one to call when something goes wrong. Whether it's a bug in the code or a mistake on your part, for the most part, transactions are irreversible. So far, we've only discussed one major application of DeFi: lending and borrowing. Some of the other fascinating innovations in the space include flash loans, which allow anyone access to multi-million dollar loans for arbitrage with no counterparty risk. Seriously, look it up. There's also bond protocols, derivative protocols that offer options, futures, and other leveraged instruments, insurance for digital assets, tokenized synthetic assets like stocks, and a whole lot more. One very popular DeFi protocol is called Uniswap, which is a decentralized exchange that allows people to trade tokens using a system known as liquidity pools. This system only requires a few parties to provide liquidity for the entire market. These parties simply deposit an equal amount of two tokens, and now anyone can trade between these two tokens. In exchange, the liquidity provider receives a fee. This has a lot of advantages over an order book exchange, especially for smaller tokens with low trading volumes. It also allows individuals to earn money from assets they already own. This is just the tip of the iceberg. The best part about the DeFi ecosystem is that it is filled with projects that all plug and play into each other like Legos. Just as the open source movement enabled developers to use other people's code to make their own apps better, these DeFi logos are accelerating the growth of the decentralized financial ecosystem rapidly. And with every new project, a whole new world of possibilities is unlocked for the entire ecosystem. Projects may compete with others, but each project inherently adds huge value to the entire ecosystem because they all work so well together. As with all new technologies, DeFi too has its drawbacks. Like we said, if something does go wrong, there is no one entity with an admin key that can fix the problem. Code is law, but if the code has a bug, it could mean irrevocable damage. Prices of assets are also driven largely by speculation, and some protocols have a lot of price exposure, which adds another layer of risk. The DeFi space is still very young, only a few years in and with less than $100 billion in the ecosystem. But it is growing at a rapid pace, and it's easy to see why. An open world of programmable money that is trustless, censorship-resistant, and actually allows participants to earn money. The majority of all DeFi projects are currently running on the Ethereum blockchain, which is on pace to settle $1.6 trillion worth of transactions this quarter itself, a 1,200% increase year over year. And it's only getting started. If you enjoyed this video, please slap a like below and make sure to subscribe to our channel. Comment below with your favorite DeFi project or anything we might have missed that you would like to see us cover in our next video.